Okay, we have here percent and trying to figure out a percentage of a certain number. All right, 14% of 34, 81% of 5. This is useful. Usually in money is where it's used. First, we need to figure out how to change a percentage into a decimal. So if I have a certain percent, let's say 23%. Okay, how I change that into a decimal is I just take the decimal that kind of is imaginary right here, and I move it two decimal spaces to the left. So 23% is the same thing as 0.23. All right, now you can give me any number. Give me 75% is the same thing as 0.75. Okay, you just take a decimal and move it two spaces to the left in order to get that. Let's see, 55%. Somebody said change that into a decimal. Okay, I take a decimal here, move two spaces to the left, and I get 0.55. Okay, and then we can actually multiply. So I have here on this 14% of 34. Well, I need to change 14% to a decimal, so I'll move it two decimal spaces over, 0.14. In math, of means times. So 14.14 times 34. Okay, and if I have to work this out by hand, I could do 14 times 0.14 over here. 4 times 4 is 16. 4 times 3 is 12. 13 because it carried the 1, and then 1 times 4 is 1, 1 times 3 is 3. Add this together, and I've got 476. But remember, I have a two decimal spots here that I got to account for, so I count two decimal spots, and the answer here is 4.76. All right, now this one, 81% of 5. Okay, it's still the same thing. Move it two decimal spaces, so 0.81 of 5 means times 5. 5 times 1 is 5. 5 times 8 is 40. Two decimal spaces amongst my question here. So I count two decimal spaces, and then I find out 4.05 is 81% of 5. All right, let's move on to our next problem. As I said, usually this is dealt with money. We have here, find 15% of $23. This is usually when somebody's trying to pay for a tip or sales tax or something like this, or maybe it's 15% off. That's what we'll say. All right, first thing they do is they change the 15% to a decimal, so 0.15, as they move this two decimal spaces over. And then they multiply it. 23 times 0.15 is 345. Okay, so if you had an item that you wanted to buy that was 23% or $23 and it was 15% off, you would take 23 and subtract 345, and it would be less than $20 is what the item would cost. That's usually where we use percentage. Save a $50 gift card. Decide what you'd like to buy and how many of each item. Calculate the total cost of your purchase, including the 9% sales tax, which is a little lower than what it is here. Bring your items up to the cashier when you're ready to check. Okay, let's say I need some sunglasses. So I'm going to bring this up to the cashier, 21.72, but I have to figure out the sales tax. The sales tax is 9%. Well, if I move the decimal over, let's do this up here. If I have 9% and I move a decimal over, I'm supposed to go two spots, and there's only one spot. Well, just go ahead and move it two, and it would be 0.09. So you would have 2172 times 0.09. Okay, and figure that out, and your answer would have to be move over four decimal spaces. Let's cheat on this one. Let's go to our calculator, 2172 times 0.09. So we have 0.09 times, I believe it was 2172. So $1.95, about $1.96, let's say. Okay, so if I go back, the way they would write this problem is 9% of 2172 is, we said it was $1.95. We're going to round up, even though that probably should be rounded down. Let's just write it as $1.95. So 9% of 2172 is $1.95.